So we should not see mala as an ornament. You know, many times I see many Dharma friend mics, a very beautiful expensive mala, not just to use for practice, but in fact just to use as an honor. To look at the, to appreciate the quality. But mala is more important than just an ornament, because it's a ritual object we must possess.
事实上呢，对于念珠来讲，我们不能够用装饰品来对待它。我们可以说，他常常看到很多的师兄弟呢，事实上，他所虽然手上拿着这个念珠，但是呢，他是心态上呢，却不是把念珠拿来作为修法的必需品，而是作为一个装饰品，甚至呢，是炫耀给他人的。所以呢，他非常重视他念珠所用的材料、所用的品质。
Now, mala. Mala is important. Now, what kind of mala that we must look for? There are three different grades. You know, of course, the best grade would be made out of all the precious gems, such as could be diamond, could be ruby, could be any object that is very precious, because mala is not an ornament, it's a sort of offering.
Yeah,
it's an offering, so it's okay to possess the most expensive object, material that used for mala, if one can afford. But then it doesn't mean that one should sell everything and buy very expensive mala. It doesn't that mean that at all. Yeah, and if you're saying in the middle grade, mala is made out of good quality seed. And at least if you're saying the lowest grade, mala should be made out of a good quality of wood, a good quality of stone, and sometimes, I think there is a tradition to make mala bead from medicinal herbs. You know, you make it like a ball, and then you make a hole, and you put string inside the ball, and you use a mala. So this kind of quality that we should try to look for. And if you cannot find all these qualities of any of this mala, then you should look for a bodhicitta. You know, this is called bodhicitta. Can be used for all purposes. And it is also not expensive, it is also not cheap, but it's affordable, you know, everybody can afford. So this quality is the best quality for mala. The mala that you should never use made of plastic, you know, a very cheap kind of plastic, and a very cheap kind of wood, and made of very cheap quality, from cheap quality mala. This kind of mala you should try to avoid, because mala is also part of offering.
再来呢，是我们现在如果要选择念珠的话呢，要选择什么样的念珠呢？因为念珠既然这个重要，那念珠的选择的这个品质呢也很重要。一般来讲，我们选择念珠呢，可以分成三种程度。 第一种呢是一个最好的程度呢，就是我们取珍贵的宝石来作为念珠的材料，那像包含钻石或宝石等等都可以，因为呢念珠的本身也是供养的，所以说呢你要用珍贵的宝石来做的话呢也是非常好的。那当然最重要的是我们的命能够负担得起，那我们可以做这样的供养。那也不必说非要，如果不需要非要这样子不可的话呢。 在中等程度上呢，我们可以用的好的品质的种子来作为念珠。那这是中间的情况。那最整合下之的呢，也就是说最比较稍微比较一般的就是呢，我们可以拿这个好的木头或者是石头来做念珠。那有一些传承呢，他们是用药丸，把药丸中间钻入洞，然后穿线过去呢来做念珠。 这三种呢，就是我们选择念珠的这三种的等级。如果说呢，我们要以广泛来讲的话呢，最为广用的念珠呢，就是菩提子。那菩提子呢，它既不贵，也不是便宜。 而且呢，它的本身呢，它可以任何的法门呢都可以使用。那我也可以随处可以买得到，我也供养得起。所以呢，算起来不一定是最好的念珠。那但是呢，念珠呢选择念珠材料的时候呢，切记呢不能够使用塑胶做的或者是便宜的木头或者是便宜的念珠。那这个呢是一定要避免的，因为念珠的本身也是供养。
So mala is important. Now, you cannot just get buy mala and use. There are certain malas that you should try to avoid. For instance, it says you should never take mala from butchers, you know, and you should never accept mala from someone who has broken samaya with your teachers. Yeah, and you should never buy a mala who has stolen from somewhere else. And you should never take use a mala that is robbed by someone else. Yeah? And you should never use a mala that is already offered to Buddha. Sometimes when you buy an expensive mala, so we put on Buddha's neck, you know, as an offering like this. So when you want to use, you cannot remove from Buddha and use. Once you offer, then it's offered, you know, you cannot use. And you cannot use a mala, the number is not right, like 99, 88, or you know, not 108, yeah? And then mala, that is like, has some, suppose it's burned a little bit, or eaten by insect, or eaten by other animals, you cannot use that kind of mala. And mala, you should never keep on the floor. If suppose if animal jumps over the mala, that kind of mala you should never use. So that means mala, if you are using, then you should use. Otherwise, you can put on your neck, or you can put it, if you feel uncomfortable, you can put inside your back. Yeah? Yeah, that's what you can do. But don't leave anywhere, everywhere.
在我们使用念珠的时候呢，那么很重要的是我们要知道呢，念珠的来源。那通常呢，我们来看第一个呢，我们念珠呢不能够从这个屠夫那边拿到念珠。第二个呢，是我们不能够从哈和上师或三个结界人那边拿到念珠。第三个呢，我们不能够呢。 用这个自抢夺过来的念珠，这个都使用。然后第五个呢是，如果这个念珠你已经呢，假设有一个非常材料非常贵的念珠，你把它供养到佛像上面去了，那已经你供养佛了，就不能够再拿回来使用，这样的念珠是不能使用的。第六个呢是，如果这个念珠呢数目呢不足一百零八，可能99啊，或者是100多，不到一百零八的念珠呢是不能使用的。 七个呢是，如果这个念珠呢，它本身有烧毁啊，或者里面有虫啊，或者有破损这样子的话呢，这个念珠呢也不能够使用的。还有呢，第八个是，当我们在使用念珠的时候呢，你不能够把它呢随处乱放，不能够特别不能放在地板上，因为也许不小心就有小动物跳过去。那所以说呢，我必须要非常的小心的这个念珠所放置的地方。 那如果说你愿意放可以放，你可以挂在脖子上，或者是说你觉得挂在脖子上不舒服的话呢，你可以放在口袋，或者是你准备好的小袋子里面。切记呢是千万不能够呢随意放置念珠。So
and when you get a new mala, one should use a saffron water to sprinkle on the mala, or use the saffron water to wash mala. And then one has to bless the mala, then if you use, then the merits and the benefits becomes much larger, you know, much stronger and better.
当我们买了新的念珠的时候呢，那要处理它呢。首先第一个呢是你可以拿藏红花，藏红花的水呢洒在念珠上面，或者用藏红花的水呢去洗这个念珠，那加持它。 那经过加持之后呢，这个念珠才使用的。因为使用加持过后的念珠呢，可以让我们的功德呢更为增长，而且。
These are very, very important. And you know the trend nowadays, you buy outside, you know, you buy from a department store this string. Otherwise, if you go accordingly, if you go strictly according to requirement, you have to make yourself. You use one string or three string, represent three kayas, five string, five Buddha family, nine string, nine yanas, you know. You make one string, a stronger one. Otherwise, nowadays you buy from supermarket, so you don't have to worry about that. And the mala, like suppose, like this mala, all the beads should be in one size. You know, you cannot have a many different size in one mala. Otherwise, it will become like a hippie's mala.
那再来呢，讲到念珠的每一根珠子，每一个珠子的尺寸呢都要一样大小，千万不要有大小颗参差不齐。如果你参差不齐的话，就像细皮的念珠一样。Okay.
And now, okay, the space between, you know, the malas cannot be too tight. Okay, cannot be too tight. According to the text, if it's too tight. It like among the mala, you know, if it's the among the mala, among the beads, if it's too tight, then according to text, whatever reason you are using the mala to recite mantra, your goal may be not realized. So it cannot be too tight among the mala. Okay, and again. Among the beads, you know, like the string, if it's too wide, then you may face with the obstacle. Then again, you may not realize your goal. Yeah, and mala cannot be too short. I've seen some of the mala, you know, like too short, like so short, you know, so short, you hardly can see and use. If it's like that, then you know it affects your lifespan. It may affect your lifespan. And then if the mala is too long, I've seen some mala so long, then your goal, you know, may become a distant dream very long, because long mala. We never use this Shaolin temple. Kung Fu master they use for Kung Fu. Not by us, so it should not be too long, should not be too short. You know, should be right just this size. I think this is right size. Can be a little bit smaller, it's okay. Can be a little bit bigger, okay. Not too big, not too big, not too small, yeah.
念珠之间的间隔，珠子跟珠子之间的间隔呢，首先呢不能够太紧。如果太紧的话呢，会变成说我不管是做任何的修法或者是念咒、修持呢，都没有办法放松。如果是太宽的话，如果珠子跟珠子之间间隔太宽的话呢，会对我们产生障碍，我们没有办法去证悟到我们最后的目标。如果说念珠呢，这个整条整串念珠呢，也不能够太短，因为如果呢，第一个太短了，你不好去使用它。 不好去拨弄它，同时也会影响到我们的寿命。而念珠呢，也不能够太长。我们听到有些人的念珠呢，长到膝盖这样子啊。
And like even the string, if it's broken, then you should change immediately. Don't keep for weeks and months. At least next day you must try to change the string. If you do not know how to change, you can request Lama or anyone who knows how to change the string. You must change the string, and you should never keep for overnight, few days.
那如果说你不知道怎么换新的线，可以说拜托被换穿线的人或者亲人来帮你忙。那最重要的就是呢，你的线如果断掉了，最好呢能够不要隔夜，或者是不要隔好几天才换线，能够越换换线是越好。Okay.
If suppose if you yourself if you want to make this mala, if your string is broken, then there is a moon sun disc on the right hand, which signifies method, and moon disc on the left hand, which signifies wisdom. So you should hold the bead, you know, bead like this, and then use the, hold the string. Then when you make, when you put inside the hole each time, you cannot just put, keep putting inside the hole or keep watching, you know, while you're watching television, then you make your mala, or while you're talking to someone else, you make like your mala. You should never do that. When you're making a mala, you should always recite this mantra, Om. So when you're making this mala, you have to recite Om, 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 Om. Then you have to make this mala.
那假设呢是当我们线断掉了，我们要自己穿的时候呢，这个时候呢，我们要有方法。第一个呢，就是呢，你把线跟珠子呢都准备好。那同时呢，你要观想在你的右手掌当中有个太阳，这个太阳呢代表的是方便，善巧方便。在你的左手掌当中呢有个月亮，月亮呢代表的是智慧。然后呢，用右手拿着线，左手拿着念珠，左手拿着珠子。 然后呢，非常专注的呢，把这个线呢穿到珠子这边。那当我们每次在穿的时候呢，一定要非常的专注，千万不能自己说，一边看着电视，一边跟着人家讲话，然后来穿珠子，这个都这样子的。那当我们在穿珠子，然后穿线的时候呢，你要一边穿一边念，嗡嗡嗡，像刚才那个线这样子的念诵一样，这样子呢，一边念诵，一边观想，然后一边穿珠子。Okay.
And do you know what this signifies? We call it dōjin. Yeah, what? Do you know what this bit signifies? And the string?
还有线代表什么意思吗？有知道的人举举手。我不知道。
The string, you know, the we call it donzin. This head of the mala signifies body, speech, and mind. And according to this text, you know, as a requirement, you know, like there's a blue color on the top, a little bit bigger in the middle, a red color, and the below bigger one should be white color. So it signifies body, speech, and mind of the deity. Suppose if it's Tara, then it is the body, speech, and mind of the Tara. And the string signifies Tara. Yeah? And all the beads signifies entourage of Tara. So there are a lot of meanings, you know, it's not just an object.
那一般来讲的话呢，在我们念经木把它分成金头，还有念珠，这个珠子跟线来讲的话呢，金头本身呢，就是代表的是一般来说呢，要把它弄成三层。那这三层呢，就代表了本尊的身与意。那一般来说呢，最上面的这个念珠呢，是用蓝色的，然后呢，在第二层呢是稍微大一点，是红色的。再来最下面的第三层呢，是白色的。 那这三层呢，假设呢，我们现在要修持以这个绿度母来讲的话呢，它就是代表这个本尊绿度母的身与意。而在念珠的珠子，念珠的线来说，线本身呢就是代表的本尊啊。假设呢，我们自己修绿度母为主的话呢，这个线本身就是代表度母。那珠子本身的每一个珠子呢，就是代表度母或者本尊的眷属。
And the reason why we need to recite mantra Hong, the letter Hong syllable Hong is Hong is a very powerful word. Hong is a word. It destroys, eradicates our suffering, and it destroys all form of evil forces. It dispels all form of evil forces. And Hong is a word that cuts the rope of samsara. So that means it liberates us. So it's not just a syllable, a letter, but it's a powerful letter to be recited.
那一般来说呢，为什么我们要念？当我们在穿这个种子的时候，穿这个念珠的时候，要念"Hong"呢？因为"Hong"呢，这个字呢本身是非常有力量的一个字。那"Hong"呢，它本身代表的是呢，能够摧毁的、摧毁所有的这个间痛苦，去除我的痛苦，并且呢，能够呢，去除掉、摧毁掉所有的邪恶的力量。那甚至于呢，它可以切断、断除我们轮回的根本。所以呢，"Hong"本身来讲的话呢。
它甚至呢，可以说是能够救助我们的一个非常最重要的一个字。而"Hong"本身呢，它不单单是一个种子之物，它也是非常有力量的字。Okay, that's how we need to visualize. Now, so far, are you clear? 你们听得懂吗？大家懂吗？我听不懂。我们现在呢，就是到目前为止的，我们现在开始有关，就是说我们在穿念珠。
来主要分享的部分，来念珠本身所代表的意义，各位有没有听懂呢？听得懂，听得懂。So
I will bless this. We will bless our mala according to this text. Okay. So, okay, you should put your hand like this. Put your mala on your right, left hand. Make it like a snake, and keep this head of the mala on the in the center. On the right hand, we visualize moon sun disk, which symbolize method, aspect of practice. On the left hand, we visualize moon, which signifies wisdom, aspect of practice. And then we visualize this mala as a tara, supposed tara, and with the entourage. And then we invite tara and dissolve into this mala, and then we concentrate the mala, you know, then mala becomes a very powerful spiritual object.
在我们刚才讲到穿完念珠之后呢，我们接下来就要讲到是要加持念珠。加持念珠的时候呢，首先呢，你将这个念珠呢拿起来，就像如现所说的呢，然后呢将念珠呢绕在这个左手掌心。 好像这个蛇呢盘起来一样，那这个时候呢，同时这个念珠的这个钧头呢是放在所有念珠的上面。再来呢，观想你的右手掌的中间有一个太阳啊，有个太阳，就是有一个日轮，代表的是这个善巧方面。而在左手掌心呢，有个月轮，有个月亮，它代表的是智慧。那当我们将这个念珠呢是放在有这个月亮的这个左手掌心这样子呢，我们就要观想。 念珠的本身，它就是我们所观的这个本尊，还有它的眷属。像这里面呢，我们是用绿度母来做的话呢，就代表念珠本身是本尊、绿度母，还有它的眷属。 那本身在无观想，我们就引起本尊念珠，我们的念珠。那我们非常专注的在做引起本尊进入的时候呢，非常的专注在念珠上面。那这样经过这样子的祈请呢，我们加持之后呢，就使得我们的念珠是一个非常有力量的这个修法的用品。
大家可以把你的手上的念珠拿起来，像我们建议刚才所讲的，说佛我就到，说我的嘛，说佛我就到嘛，众生啊，在满年代的，看见成都，坐在一堂座，千万不见那么多就在过了，念书也多，甚至三分的，我个人在一起简单的。 那我把我念诵那巴拉的，就多久就能朗读，论经读，这些讲究三宝是，后来见锻炼这边，我来下瓦嘞，原来也把那个念些些，他们说什么就念念不啊，那我怎么念念的东哥，我就跟他们这边那对讲读，就我们罗斯罗曼的，罗斯罗曼的，罗斯罗曼的，罗斯罗曼的，罗斯罗曼的，罗斯罗曼的。 罗什那曼那卓阿宗，罗什那曼那卓阿宗，罗什那曼卓阿宗，玛哈伊伊乌乌日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日日 Pama Yaralo Washaka Sahanja
and then invite this wisdom deity and dissolve into the mala, and then you recite Rujaramana at least 7 times, and then after that Sudha Chitta Bhadra, then blow the mantra 3 times, you recite 3 times, then you know, rub the mala and blow the mala, then stand. Then if you do that, then your mala becomes more effective. And the sutra says, like if you recite 1 time, it's like, you know, it multiplies into thousands. Otherwise, without the blessing, proper blessing of mala, then it is less effective. So you should try to do it every day.
No.
Not every day, at least. like us, we do every day when we have this morning prayer. So we bless every day. If not, like at least 3 days, 4 days, 1 time. You know, at least like 3 times a week.
刚才呢，龙倩的代刚刚就做的是念经的常会的加持。那卢倩说呢，事实上我们自己呢，也可以自己做的是比较结会的方式呢，就是呢，将这个念经呢放在这个手上，做同样的观想右手的太阳，左手的月亮。那我们做，然后念经放上，我们观想念经呢，它是理所观的这个本尊，这个本尊都可以。然后引起智慧的尊呢，本尊的智慧尊降临进入。 那当他我们要帮他进入的时候呢，各位手上呢有给跟大家发给大家是加持念珠咒。首先呢，我们先念第一句的加持念珠咒呢，念七次，念七次之后呢，然后呢再来呢再念第二句，第二句呢念三次，念了三次之后，你将这个念珠放在手掌心当中搓一搓，然后再吹气这样子。 那这样子的话呢，会使我们所使用的念珠呢是更有力量、更有效果的。那在依照仁切开示所用的依据的这个经典里面所讲的话呢，如果我们能够用这样的方式来加持念珠，会使我们每念一个咒语的效应呢是有千倍的效果。那所以说呢，能够用这样的方式呢，使我们的念珠呢是更有力量。那当然说仁切说呢。 对于他们来讲的话呢，他们通常做早课的时候呢，是每天一定会做这个加持念珠的功课。那但是如果对我们来讲的话呢，至少一个礼拜呢要三次，也就是说三天或四天一次，至少呢一个礼拜呢三次做这个加持念珠的功课。
And there is another mantra that you can see from this piece of paper of Abhira Kensarehu. This is not for blessing. This is a mantra when you eat food. You know, if you do not know other prayers, when you eat, especially when you eat meat or when you drink, before you drink liquor or meat, if you recite a few times and blow on the meat or liquor, it's supposed to help the animal and it will help you also. Yeah? So this is a mantra that you should try to recite every day. You know, when you eat anything, it will be less sin. But this doesn't mean that when you drink a liquor, Abhira Kheta, then you drink all Abhira Kheta. You cannot drink all the time. Right?
那在这个加持念珠咒语第三句的咒语啊，事实上它不是在加持念珠，它是使得我们能够持诵咒语的这个履历啊，是更为精进。也就是说，是我们在念在吃肉之前，或者在喝酒之前，如果在餐前你能够念这个咒语的话。 那会使得我们念诵这个咒语的咒力啊，会因为吃了肉或者是喝了酒而丧失。所以说，我们最好能够在每天在吃饭前、餐前，如果特别是没有吃这个肉食或者喝酒之前，能够念这个咒是更好。当然，也不能够说一喝一口酒、一口肉呢，然后就念这个咒语，一口酒、一口肉就念这个样子啊。Okay.
And now, how we hold this mala? You know, there are occasions that you may use your right hand. You know, there are occasions such as certain wrathful mantras, you use the right hand. But mostly, you should always use your left hand. Never use right hand. Always use left hand. Huh?
一般来讲呢，再来就讲到我们要怎么样去拿念珠、拨念珠来念啊。那一般来说，除非是有一些愤怒尊，他可以使用右手。 但是大部分来说呢，我们如果一旦要使用念珠的话，我一定是用左手，千万不能够用右手来使用念珠。
And always pull in like this, mug, you know, like this pull in, Don't push up, never push up. Only for certain wrathful mantras, like when you're making a curse, then you push out, you know. Otherwise, you put always pull in, pull in, pull in.
那同时呢，在我们拨念珠的时候呢，千万不能够外拨，一定是往内拨，因为呢，只有少数的这个特定本尊呢，他们在修持的时候，特别他们在修一些体咒法的时候呢，才会外拨，否则的话呢，我必定呢是念珠呢拨的时候呢，一定是向内拨的。
If you do that, if you push out, then all the Buddha will run away.
如果你不向外拨的话呢，所有的佛都跑掉了。<laughs> And
Now, there is a way where you place the mala. For peaceful, I'm just going into detail, you don't have to follow all this, and I will also later explain you. If for peaceful, always close to heart, okay? And for power, close to your navel. And for increasing for your navel, and for power, close to your sacred part. And for wrathful, rest on your knee. Okay, that's how you recite the mantra. And then, for peaceful, you use your thumb and your index finger, like this, huh? Like this, huh? Like this. And for increasing, if you follow accordingly, thumb and your ring finger. Ring finger. And for power, thumb, then your ring finger. Again. And for lawful, thumb and your small finger. And also the place also go down and down and down and down and down, yeah? Yeah? This is quite difficult, quite not so comfortable to use. So what, how you can use is, according to this text, the text explains, if you use for this way, it covers for wrathful, peaceful, increasing power for all purposes. Thumb and your index finger. So most of the time, every time, you can just use this way, it covers all purposes. Thumb, index finger, and always close to your heart, like this. Always close to your heart, like this. Okay? Always close to your heart. Of course, when you are tired, then sometimes you need a helping hand, so you pull. You know, or sometimes you rest on your lap, and then you know we do that. It's okay, nothing wrong. Nobody will punish you. But if you can, always keep close to your heart like this. Say I'm sorry. Go ahead.
在用使用念珠的时候呢，会随着我们所修的本尊是行政法一修而放在我们不同的位置，同时主使用的这个手指呢也会不一样。首先呢，由介说的念珠它现在呢，就是说你不一定说全部都要照这样做，但是今天大家都要有这样的内容。首先呢，对于这个行政法一修的洗礼法的本尊来讲的话呢，其实这个时候呢，那你念诵的时候呢，你要将念珠，你要将手的是放在心轮的地方。 而当你在修这个增益增法的时候呢，你要将念珠是放在体轮的地方；而当你在修这个怀爱法的时候呢，你要将念珠呢是放在命数的地轮的地方；最后你要修这个诸法的时候呢，你要将念珠呢是放在膝盖的部位；而当我们在修这个习正怀诸法的时候呢，我们的所用的指头的这个波念珠的部位呢也不一样。 首先呢是洗法的时候呢，你在波念珠是要用大拇指跟你的食指，这是行政洗法；而在做增益法的时候呢，你要用大拇指跟中指来波念珠；而在怀爱法的时候呢，你要使用大拇指和无名指来波念珠；在修诸法的时候呢，你要用大拇指跟小拇指来波念珠；而我们在一般也就结合前面所讲的，就是你在做这个。 做这个习正法术的洗法的时候，用大拇指跟食指拨念珠，同时呢是放在心轮的地方；增益法的时候呢，是大拇指跟中指拨念珠放在体轮的地方；怀爱法呢是大拇指跟无名指在拨念珠放在密轮的地方；而在这个诸法的时候，是大拇指跟小拇指拨念珠是放在膝盖的地方。那一般来讲的话呢，这个样子对我们来说是，由于它在使用上面是非常。 困难哦，比较不容易。但是呢，有一个统筹的一个大原则，任何的法门都可以使用的话呢，就是用大拇指跟食指来拨念珠，同时呢，将这个念珠是放在心轮的位置。那这个呢，是可以说的所有的习正法诸法都可以使用。那当然，如果当我们在念珠累的话呢，我们可以稍微休息一下，或者把念珠放在嘴上也是可以。那这个是没有错的，也不会有人去惩罚你。 那当然，最好的话呢，还是说你用这食指的这样的念珠，用大拇指和食指拨念珠，然后呢，将这个念珠放在心轮的地方。OK。现在清楚吗
？Are you sure? I will ask you later.
确定哦，等一下。确定哦。
Yeah, 确定啊。And mala. It is easy to possess mala, but when you keep mala, when you possess mala, there are also samaya you have to keep. Seven samaya. Like for instance, you know why there is a vajra and veil we have always hang in this with a mala, you know. You know, once you become a Tantrayana student, according to the requirement, you must own bell, vajra and bell. Vajra signifies skillful means, such as compassion, love and compassion, and all the ways of bodhisattvas, method aspect of practice. And bell signifies wisdom, wisdom of realization. So, as a Vajrayana student, one must own Vajra and bell. So many times, due to circumstances, maybe not so convenient at home, sometimes you are not able to find the right Vajra and bell to mend this broken Samaya. We use the small two Vajra and bell hang with the mala. So it covers your broken Samaya, so you are fulfilling your Vajrayana
requirement. 也代表我们所修的法门，像是慈悲啊，或者是菩萨的六度万行。而灵呢，是代表的是智慧，也代表了我们所证悟的究竟圆满的智慧。而对于金刚寺的弟子来讲的话呢，他必定呢要准备着灵柱，同时要随身携带。但是呢，有时候很多时候很多场合跟这个时空下面的因缘呢，我不方便携带，所以为了能够呢保持我们的三昧缘界的圆满。
Now, there are major samaya and minor samaya. The major, what is major samaya? About mala. The mala, you should always keep with you. Especially the mala that you use for yidam practice, it should follow like your shadow. So wherever you go, you should carry your mala. Even you go to office, wherever you go, you know. For mala, there's no holiday. Wherever you go, you have to bring mala. Of course, only one place you cannot bring is toilet. Yeah, you don't bring. Otherwise, wherever you go, you should always keep bring your mala. The reason why you have to bring is, this is a samaya, and if you can bring mala with you all the time, then whatever reason that you are praying using this mala, your goal becomes a reachable goal. You are able to accomplish your goal. Yeah, so that's the reason why you should always bring your mala. I would advise you to have a two mala. One is always used for yina, not to show everyone, you know, not to show, always keep secret. Okay? Another one, you know, you bring everywhere, you know, you can show people, you can use for other purposes. But mala or yina must keep secret. Like olden days, you know, like Buddha's time, there are many guru who practice Tantrayana, but they always hide mala, so nobody knows what they're doing behind the shawl. You know, they always cover their mala, so nobody sees what they're using, what they're doing, what they're chanting. You know, because Tantrayana is known as a sacred yana, and the more sacred you keep, the better effect it has, and your goal becomes a reachable goal, you know.
那再来想到我们在使用念经的时候，这个三昧也界呢，它给一个主要根基两种戒律。对于念经的主要三昧也界呢，就是第一个呢，念经一定要随身携带。那特别是你所修的本尊，所修的本尊的念珠呢，一定要像如影随形一样呢，随时携带。 哪怕是你去上到办公室上班啊等等呢，也都要随身携带。唯一呢，只有可以说的念珠呢是都没有假日的。那唯一只有你到这个盥洗室的时候呢，是不要带回去的。那否则的话呢，你所放之前呢，都要把这个念珠呢是随时带在身上。那为什么说要有这样子的三昧结界呢？因为假设我们能够将这个念珠随时带在身上。 那任何我们因这个念珠所做的修持或祈请呢，会非常容易达成我的目标。也因此呢，身为金刚社的弟子呢，你要随时呢把念珠带在身边。那我们也建议大家能够呢，准备两条念珠。第一条念珠呢，是你自己专修本尊的念珠，同时这个念珠呢是一个秘密念珠，不给任何人看，也不让任何人知道。而第二条呢，是你 外出的时候呢，随时可以带在身边的这个念珠，这个念珠呢，给人家碰到，给人看到都没有关系。那这样子呢，在以前呢，在佛陀住世的时候呢，那个时候呢，当时就有很多的上师，他们呢也是修持金刚圣。那事实上呢，他们是将这个念珠呢是藏在他的法袍里面，没有人知道呢，他到底呢在这个法袍里面呢到底是在做什么修法的。 因为金刚乘来说呢，它原意呢，也就是属于这个秘密圣，那所以说呢，它的法门呢也是不公开给人家知道。也因此呢，当你能够越秘密的来修持金刚乘的法门呢，事实上它的效果呢是越有力量，而你也能够更容易的成就。
Okay, now according to secondary precepts, mala you cannot show everyone. You know, that's what we like to do. We buy a new mala, you know.
Look, my mala, they're good. How about your mala? You know, you like to share with everyone.
Oh, very good, very good. 太漂亮了，太好了。
You're not supposed to do that with a mala, you know. Husband and wife supposed to share everything, but mala you cannot share. Husband must have all his own mala, wife must have his own mala. You cannot share. And mala should not use for counting. You know, if suppose you forget your calculator and then you start to 1, 2, 3, 4. No, not allowed. Yeah? And mala should not be used for playing. You know? And mala always keep secret. Okay, always keep secret. And especially someone who has broken samaya, you know, you may have a friend, but who has broken samaya with your guru, you should never let he or she touch your mala. So in other words, mala is not something that you show around, but always keep secret, always keep hidden. Whenever you meet Rinpoche or Lama that who is genuine, then you ask for blessing, chances.
Put in some pocket. Yeah, that's what you need to do. 那另外呢，依照念珠所讲的，我们在这个念珠上面的分支的这个三昧见解，也就是说，第一个呢，你呢绝对是不能够将这个念珠呢是拿给别人看，秀给别人看，也就是说啊，好像你把念珠拿出来给人家看，说，看这个念珠太漂亮了，多好啊，这样子是不可以的。 那么所以说呢，念珠呢，它是不能够呢是显示给人家看的。那第二个呢，是即使是夫妻呢，是什么事情都可以分享，唯独只有念珠呢是不能够分享的。那即使亲如夫妻的话呢，它也是个人要有自己个人自己的念珠。再来呢，是念珠呢，你不能够拿来作为计数使用，计算它的自己次，这个是不允许的，就好像说如果你忘记带了计算机，那你拿念珠来做计数，这是不许的。 然后再来呢，念珠呢不能够来当做这个玩耍的使用的这个游戏这个玩具，而同时呢，念珠呢你一定要永远的一直把它保持秘密的，特别呢是你的念珠呢，千万不能够给这些他的上司破了三昧眼界的人去碰到你的念珠。那同时呢，是念珠呢你不能够呢，你念珠呢你一定要呢，不给人。
Now, this is all about the mala. Now, when you recite a mantra using mala, you're not supposed to speak. You know, you have to recite 108 times, then you are not supposed to speak while you're reciting mala. You know, so all my people, how are you? Oh, good morning. Then you will never finish your work. There's a lot of disturbance, you know. There's a lot of distraction there. So one should not do that. So like for instance, when you are reciting mala, suppose you have keep your telephone on and you have to say hello, then you have to recite 4 times extra. Suppose you have finished 108 times, if you say hello during that time, then you have to add 4 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4 beats. Yeah, that's it required. And then during the recitation, this thing you may not follow seriously, but if you can, it is very good. Yeah. Suppose if you know during the recitation, if you cough, then you have to add 5 times. 5 times. And then you know, if you during the recitation, yawn. Yawn. Each time, 3 times. Each time, 3 times. You know, you need to add. And then if you sneeze, you know, 10 times. So that's how, you need to add on. And especially, I think you never do this thing, you know, like, I think that this thing happens. That's why it was written very clearly, you know, the requirement. Somebody if you spit during the, recitation, you know, people who eat pinla, is it called pinla?
Yes.
Yeah. Like India, people eat pan, you know. You know, each time you spit, you have to add 1 more time. Yeah. But this thing you don't do, so you don't have to worry all about all this. But one have to make sure that when you during the recitation, make sure that you switch off your telephone, switch off television, and then you recite with total concentration. Then the effect is much, much stronger. Because what happens is, I want to watch television, then if you recite, then, you know, you are just counting the number, but you are not there. You know? So it's less beneficial.
那一般在我们这个念诵咒语的时候呢，原则上是不可以讲话的，也就是说，当你念诵一串念经的时候，100%你发是比较非常不专注。那否则的话呢，如果说你一下子增加打招呼啊，但是这个压力好啊这样子，那你永远呢就没有办法圆满的100%你发力这样的技术。那所以说，当我们在这个依照这个基点上呢，有技术到说呢，有一些呢是如果说我们在念诵咒语的时候，修法的时候。 有一些状况出现的时候呢，我们必须要去弥补这样子的这些弥补料。就好像呢，第一个，假设呢，你电话来了，你接电话或者说一声 hello， 那你这样子呢，你就要用这个比这个4倍来弥补它。那或者是说呢，你在念诵的时候呢，咳嗽一声，那你就要再补5倍。那或者是说你念诵的时候呢，这一颗念珠在念诵的时候你打呵欠了，那你就要补3倍。 那或者是说呢，你在这个念诵的时候呢，打了喷嚏，那你就要这个补10倍。那或者是说，像有些人呢，他是吐痰，吐槟榔吐痰这样子。那这个时候呢，你又要再增加1倍。那最重要的就是说，当你在修法的时候，当然前面这个部分呢，你可以很严格的这样子去执行，也可以说不必要那么严格的执行。 但是原则上最重要的就是，当我们在修持的时候呢，一定要把电话啦、电视啦都把它关起来，非常专注的这样子的持诵，这样子呢会让我们的修行的成果呢会更有力量。那千万不要说一边看着电视，一边手中握着念珠，好像还在口中呢这个念念有词的在念个咒语。
And many times we wonder, how can I recite 100,000 times, Zambala never show up to me? Why? You know, we always ask, I recite Tara 100 times, nothing. Meo,
Ganjue, is it?
Ganjue. No feeling. Why? We always ask, you know. The reason is because we are not reciting properly, we are not holding mala properly, and especially even the food. I would advise you, not every day, it's impossible to do every day, but when you go for a retreat, these are the food that you need to be watchful. Like for instance, Sangyu Rinpoche Kutane, one of the Tantrayana Sutra says, you know, this wild garlic, if you eat wild garlic, it affects your power of mantra 9 days. It will subdue the power of mantra for 9 days. And then, especially if you eat animal tongue, it affects for 21 days. Yeah? And ordinary onion, ordinary like garlic and pepper affects for 3 days. You know, 3 days, according to this text. And also, like, if you do not recite prayer, like we have just learned the mantra, blow on meat or liquors, wine, if you just drink, it affects for 5 days. You know, it affects for 5 days. And the worst effect comes from lying and making divisive speech, using harsh word. This affects for long time. So we have to be careful overall. All forms of non-virtue acts, one has to be watchful and careful not to use this word, you know, in such manner. It is very, very important. But the food, you know, we cannot really watch everything, because you go to a restaurant, you cannot say, don't put this, don't put that. The restaurant may say, oh, something wrong with you, right? Yeah? So it's okay, but if you're going for a retreat, then try to avoid all this food.
再来呢，是一般我们通常都会在想说，为什么我这么这样子精进来修持，甚至于呢财神啊或度我这个东西的十万遍呢，可是呢都没有感觉呢，跟度我也没感觉，财神也不出现给我看，那为什么会这个样子呢？那事实上最主要的原因就是因为我们的修法的并不如法，那我们也没有去如法的使用念珠，那特别是呢有时候呢食物呢对我们来说也是有影响力的。 当然，这个一般来说呢，我们一般吃食物是没什么，但是我们如果是在闭关的时候呢，食物呢也是很重要的。依照呢这个密训里的经典呢所说的话呢，在我们食物选择上面呢，特别是在闭关的时候，假设我们吃的是口味很重的咖喱，会使得我们在念诵咒语的这个咒力呢会丧失9天。那假设呢我们吃了动物的舌头。 会使得我们的这个念诵咒语的咒力丧失21天，那或者是说呢，应该说是影响21天，那或者是说呢，我们吃了这个姜葱啊、蒜啊，还有胡椒，会影响我们的咒力3天。那另外呢，是如果我们没有念诵这些这个加持这个肉啊跟酒的咒语，那就直接吃这些肉或酒的话呢，会影响我们的咒力5天。 那印象我们最严重的呢，就是说谎。那说谎会影响我们非常的深远。那甚至于像这个两舌啊，或者是假设称谶语啊，这个呢都会影响到我们的咒力。那千万呢要记住说，千万不能够因为恶小的而为之。那事实上呢，有些事情我们能够避免，但是最好的，当然如果说像这个食物的选择，一般我们在外面餐厅吃饭的话呢，如果说我们跟这个
Sometimes these are the things that you should know. I think if you know this, it will help you in practice. Yeah. So that's all about mala. Now, if you have any question, you can ask me now.
那以上呢？
It also counts as a replacement. But if you can get a new one, it's better. You know, if it's, the number is not complete, yeah, it's better.
那能不能说如果说当然你念住这样子断掉改掉，如果你可以找到同样大小的念住你，给它再用回来是可以的，再穿是可以的。那假设说你找不到，你又找其他的来代替的话，那这样子你还不如找不找一个转换新的念住重新念回就好了。
不是，只是剩下不够一百零八克的，对不对？
对，那个剩下的那些怎么处理
？So how to give the 100 and the old one? How to treat it?
Oh, you can keep in your door. Otherwise, you can you know, bring to forest, and where there is a hole, in the tree, some of the tree you have a hole, so you can just put it inside, or you can put inside the rock. Mm-hmm. Keep it clean. That's okay.
那如果那个树呢刚好树枝刚刚有洞，你可以放在洞里面，就放在清净的地方，这样子把它丢在那里就可以了。不好意思，我想问一下，如果那个上次送给的那个就是西运节啊，就绑在这个佛的这个柱子的头啊，这样可以吗？那如果绑在这边代表什么意思？这两个问题。
You make like a flower and you something you have or something.
Here's the question because the 但是上方有个师兄问到说，猪头的部分啊，它有三层，一个蓝色，一个红色，一个白色，那就分别代表本尊的身体意，把它们代表本尊的身体意。
Yes.
And the dosing means the how we reciting at the end into the dosing. Should we cross or
no? Dosing is not the yidam, yeah. Dunzin is body, speech, and mind.
Yes.
The string is yidam.
Okay.
I never came across, maybe there is some other text, but I also asked few Rinpoche, older one. They never give me a straightforward answer, and they also probably never came across. But there is a verbally said that when you reach Dunzin, you turn, and you know then you keep reciting. There's a verbally such thing is there, but there's not in the text. So it's okay. If you want to do it, you can do it. If you don't want to do it, let it be.
那怎么解说呢？事实上呢，有很多人呢，就是要口述的口传，就这样子告诉他说，这个念珠你播到口的时候，你要回过来，很多都这样说。但是怎么解也，其实曾经去查过经典，没有一个经典说你一定要回过头来。那所以说，也就上呢，就是变成说，你要跨过去也可以，你不跨过，你要回过头来念也是可以的，并没有说经典上有强制的。
有很明白的解释，说这样子，所以是不必说，按照你自己这样一步一步挂案算。什么的可以？什么的可以？我想再问两个问题。第一个就是，刚刚能够解释提到，可是不是我问题，就是那真的有动物跨过去怎么处理？那第二个问题就是说，这个它有三颗猪这样的那个吗？ 那个如果有算，好像不能算，如果有算的话，会不会不如法？OK，there's
two questions. First, if the mala is caused by animal, and how to treat it?
Okay.
And secondly, for the smoking or the, so should we account or not account?
No, that's the you don't count.
Okay.
Yeah. If suppose animal jumps over your mala, you know, then you can use sprinkled water to, you know, spray and then you recite the mantra, you know, blessing mala. Mm-hmm. Then you can do, again, it, you know, mend your broken samaya.
那如果说你的念珠呢有被这个小动物跨过的话呢，你可以拿这个藏红花水把它撒一撒，然后呢照德布天主教的加持念珠咒这样子这个方法来修，这样的话你的念珠就重新再用了。那另外呢，就是这个隔珠的部分哦，它不算计数的，不算数字的，就是隔珠这样子。就是两个问题，就是如果。 手边有那一种，就是比如说来请了之后才知道来源不清净的那一种念珠，或是说那一种就是比如说已经被或上面也接触过的那一种佛像，就是一般我们楼下在展示那一种照相的那一种，那一种是应该怎么处理会比较适合？And
you just mentioned the mala, the source of mala is that comes from the steel or something broken samaya, something. If we got this mala, it's from the some steel or some from some broken samaya they touch, how to treat the mala?
Best, I think broken samaya is more serious with your teacher, yeah? That's yes. More serious. Best, if you even somehow, if you have to accept, just accept and you can give to someone else, you keep it, you know. But don't use for enough practice. Or otherwise, you can just bless your mala, then it's okay.
And other thing is when we go to down the shop, and some of many people they touch the mala before we use. Also maybe some of they broke
the mala. That's why when you buy a mala, you should not just immediately use for your yidam practice.
Mm-hmm.
You should bless your mala. Mm-hmm. Then only you should use. First, initially you use, in the beginning you use suffering water, to sprinkle on the mala and then bless your mala, then you can use. Or you can ask Lama or Rinpoche to bless your mala.
那对于这个念珠来讲，假设呢它是给你知道它来源不清净了，或者是给那些破的三昧缘界的人碰过的话，那原则上来说，特别是碰过三昧缘界的人这些梦过的话，因为它比较严重的，所以最好这个念珠要么就是放在一边，或者送人家，你自己不要拿来做本尊的修法的念珠。好，那至于说你在卖场上面的这些念珠的话，因为很多人碰到。 所以最好就是你新的念珠拿来，最好呢先给它净化，就是用这个藏红花水净化。但如果说有人不是来请他加持之后，你再开始修本尊的念珠。那如果是在没有这个之前没有这样的净化加持之前，不要拿来做本尊的念珠的修持。
那佛像部分。
How about the Buddha status? If some Buddha status also touched by the some people with broken samaya, so how would you do that?
There's no samaya. That's why once you buy a statue, once you invite a statue to your home, and you can invite Rinpoche or any lama to make consecration. recite a prayer, you know, so that helps. Every time, yeah, that's what we do.
She said that some of the Lama give a gift the mala without the central one.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah, it's okay. 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 It's okay.
It's
十本就是说一个是外，就是戴在外面用的。它是不是那个绿绿的，那个要戴在身上？Oh, so this you just suggest that we prepare two mala, and one is that we practice the Alidam section, the other one is to show outside. But since we have to bring the mala all the time, so the section also we have to bring all the time or just a little at home. There's a two.
No, normally, because when you do a serious practice, we always do at home, you know. But if you are doing at an office, then you know you may bring. You know? But as long as you don't show, you know, you don't show the other people, you don't let other people touch, then you can just bring one mala. It's okay. But if you always like to show others, if always share with friends, then you know it's better to keep a secret as possible.
那一般来讲的话，假设我们要在家里，要在座上修法，一旦严格修法的话，一般都是在家里，绝对不可能说到外面办公室边走边修法。所以这样的念珠呢，是一定的，都是放在家里的。那除非说是你有带出办公室的话呢，那假设那这个是另当别论。但如果说你是你的念珠，你也是，即使是带到办公室，你也不给人家看到，你是保持的非常秘密的话。 那其实这样子一条念珠也就够了，一条念珠也就够了。那最重要的就是说，你在修，你平常你在修的，最主要的这个念珠呢，是不给人家看到的，不给人家碰的，这是重点。
I think tonight all of you will drink mala.
陈德先生，你们今天晚上的梦一定都是梦到念珠，全都是念珠。
Don't come back to me saying, "Oh, Rinpoche, the mala chased me everywhere."
Yeah.
Normally 25, 30.
And 38?
Yeah, 38.
From
Dongzhi?
From Dongzhi to here. How many?
And this one is
10.
Yes.
And the other side also is 10.
Yeah,
10. 那事实上没有严格的规定，在今年上也没有严格的规定，那有的人是看他自己使用上方便这样子，对。我才看过一个，后面有个师兄，江生，我是想请上师在我们念一下这三个咒。
OK，我们就
please give us the room for the mantra.
We don't want
to recite the prayer.
Om. Rojiramani. Rojiramani. Some recite Benza, some recite Vajra, it's the same. Which one?
The 哪一句还是全部？
全部。 Like it says here, you know, Gongyu is again another Tantrayana Sutra. When you recite a mantra, when you say a mantra, yeah, you know, in mantra, if you recite so slowly, too long, then, you know, your breath, you know, maybe not enough. You are not able to pronounce. And if you recite, you know, too short, you know, and then, you know, like, you know, something like that. So, right, so that, then, you know, it may affect your health. your health. And when you recite mantra, if you recite with so much force, something like that, you know, it affects your health. And sometimes it affects also other beings. You know? So, and if your mantra is again, it's too soft, then you know it's not powerful enough. Not powerful enough. If you recite mantra too slow, then you cannot finish the requirement number. And if you recite your mantra too fast, and you may not be able to pronounce right. So when you recite mantra, shouldn't be too fast, shouldn't be too slow, cannot be too much of force, cannot be very little force, so it should be right amount of force and speed. Very, very important.
那一般在这个经典上面来提到说呢，当我们念诵咒语的时候呢，你最好能够采取中庸之道呢，也不要太快、太慢，也不要太用力，也不要太软、太硬啊。比如说呢，你念的太长的话，你的这个咒语是能念的太长的话，你可能这个呼吸都喘不过来，气不够啊。那如果是念的太短的，像这个大的这样很短的话呢，会影响到你的健康。 那又如同，又如果说你念咒语的时候呢，太用太大的力气来念咒语的话呢，那非但会影响到你自己的健康，还会影响到其他的人。那又如果你在念咒语的时候呢，是太软大发的这样念诵咒语的话呢，就没有力量。那如果你念诵咒语的话呢，太慢的话呢，又没有这个会使得你的没有办法圆满的要念诵咒语的次数，或者是说你念诵咒语太快的话呢。 会让你念诵咒语的这个咬字呢会不清楚，重音呢就不正确了。所以说呢，我们在念诵咒语的时候呢，也不能够太长，也不能太短，也不能够太用力，也不能够太软，也不能够太快，也不能够太慢。最好的能够有中庸之道的这样子才是念诵咒语的最好的方法。
那就想请问上师那个一件事情哈，有的时候那个在修，譬如说，假设说是那个四臂观音的话，那中间有一段是就是念 Om Mani Padme Hum
哈，有的时候听到就很多喇叭或者是一般的居士，他们很厉害，就是念久了就这样，就我不太会学，就是因为你只听到一个，
只有一个 Om
那样的话，这个会有问题吗？
She practiced some Dharma practices such as the form chanting, and during the reciting the six of the form chanting, some of them they just reciting very quickly, and the sound is clear like just one voice. So this is the any problem of this okay for them to recite the Mani Hum that tomorrow like very quickly some of them. And when you outside people will hear just that Om Mani Padme Hum, it's like woo, something like that. It's like that.
I think mantra, if you're doing yidam practice, the mantra should not recite too fast, not too slow, the right amount of speed. Because if you recite too fast, then you may somehow not pronounce well. You know. And if it's too slow, then it also becomes a problem. Yeah, it may not complete the requirement number. So it has to be the right speed, you know, right force.
那如天说呢，事实上在我们修持本尊的时候呢，是千万不能够念诵咒语的话呢，不能够太快，不能够太慢。那速度上呢要适中。 因为如果你念得太快的话呢，你没有办法正确的将每一个咒音呢都正确的发音，而如果你念得太慢的话呢，也会影响到你将你的这个功课呢圆满的这个时辰。所以最好的方式呢，就是能够呢正确的呢这个快慢的速度呢非常合一的方式呢，将这个咒语来修本尊比较好。OK。
因为我参加过上师有蛮多次法会哈，那一开始的时候都有那个百字明咒，可是。
You are the initiation and teaching many times. So the special with the initiation, when we reciting the book is about. So when we reciting the three times the blue, you're always smiling. So why are you smiling? She just doubt.
Why smile?
Yeah.
Just because
ha 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 ha. 好像我觉得是好像是我们念错那个调子。哦，不是。No,
no, different. You know the where they, you know, raise the voice, where they, you know, reduce the voice, bigger.
这张是。各位先，这张是呀，不如哦，哈哈哈。I
said. I think you, I hear
So,
if we only practice our Yidang, when we recite the mantra, should we recite it in the inside, divine or not? Voice
I think that some amount of the force has to come out.
Okay.
Cannot recite very silently. There are many kinds. One is called Yide. Yide means mind recitation.
Mm-hmm.
And this is Nade, means speech recitation. So when you recite speech recitation, because Yide, if you are meditating, if you are in meditation, then you may do the Yide. So you don't need to pronounce, you know, with a force. But when you do Nade, when you recite, when you fulfilling the requirement of the mantra, then one has to recite.
那我们念诵的事实上，当我们念诵咒语有两种方式啊，一种呢是叫做一对，一种是叫拿对。一对呢，它是在我们坐禅修的时候呢，我们有心理来念诵的。那所以说这个时候我们念诵出来是可以的。那拿对的话呢，它主要就是口诵的这个口诵咒语。所以说呢，你可以低声一点，但是一定要这样念出来。 所以这个当我们在念诵本尊法的时候呢，还是以这个拿对的口诵咒语为主。就是你可以小声的念，但是一定要出声，一定要在口语上，因为是真言圣嘛，叫口语，你可以上来用到。还有问题吗？
But like for instance, like Om Dali Tu Dali Tu Soha, you know the sound, so you just focus of the sound, and then you just recite internally, not externally, you know. So that can be done. But if you're after a number, then how you count internally? You cannot count.
那就好像假设我们在修律动母的时候呢，那我们念诵律动母的咒语呢，我们大力度大力度会说吧。如果你是专注在这个音声的时候，音声的部分呢，那你可以在内心的在内在呢是这样子的来去念诵。那可是呢，如果是说你是以这个声音的在念诵咒语为主的话，那你必定呢是要在声音要发出来，这样子呢才可以计数，这样子来算的。
She said,
if we reciting the mantra too long, sometimes the sound cannot out. The voice cannot, there's no voice, just reciting the entire like the wind goes off.
Yeah, I mean, if your health doesn't permit, then, you know, it's okay, yeah. As long as your health permits, then you should try to recite.
那当然，有师姐说，如果念诵太久，或者声音出不来，而不是说，当然如果说健康上面没有办法出来是没有关系。可是如果说我们健康上许可是尽量的念出声音来是最好。Oh, look, coma. Oh, look, coma. Oh, look, coma. Oh, look, coma.
Oh, look, coma.
She says she has been practicing more than 5 hours.
Oh, that's too long.
人家都不想太长的啦。Yeah,
we've been too long. 这样子。中间有没有休息？休息一下。一般来讲是一坐嘛，是2个小时左右吧。You know, there's a story. You know, there was a mother and son. So the mother always said, "No, no, 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 no the mother. So one day, the son started calling my mother and said, mother, you know? And the mother got angry and said, why do you always call my name? You know? So mother said, son said, I just call your name just few times, you're so angry. You know? And you've been calling name of Kwamsi Pusa for so many years. I think Kwamsi Pusa must be very angry at you.
那这个父亲啊，有一对母子，他这个母亲呢，每天呢都在念诵观世音菩萨，他每天一直都在念观世音菩萨，观世音菩萨，可是他的小孩呢就觉得他妈妈这样子念得很吵，所以有一天呢，他就一早起来呢，就一直喊着妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈妈
Okay. That's all, huh?
好, 以上是今天开始。
Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you.